Thank you, ma'am. Friends, good afternoon to everybody. I think college authorities have put you on vibration mode. I'm sure the college authorities must have told you only to put your mobile phones on vibrating mode, not yourself. So once again, good afternoon to everybody. Well, that's right. Possibly you have now switched on yourself to the right mode. Friends, dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, Hon'ble Justice Dr. B.S. Chauhan is here. Of course, a source of inspiration for all of us. I'm very much thankful to all of you, especially the organizers for this function, that I'm given an opportunity to be amongst the young people, as rightly said by Justice A.P. Shahi in the morning, that you people are the vibrant future of this country. Friends, the topic for the day is laws affecting freedom of speech and expression of India. Many of you must have studied jurisprudence by now and must be studying further. You will find that every right is bound to have a corresponding duty. Now, so far as this right to freedom of speech and expression is concerned, I remember an anecdote. And that anecdote is that in good old days, when Russia was considered to be a country with iron curtain, one Russian could escape and could come to USA, where he had learnt about that there is all freedoms of the world available in USA. So soon after getting down from the plane, he started running on the airport with both his hands spread over. When he was running, his hand hit a nose of a white man. So that white man objected to that. He said, "What are you doing?" "Sir, I'm exercising my freedom of all freedom which I have. I'm exercising that." So that white man said very nice thing. He said, "Your all freedoms are there, but your freedoms come to an end where my nose begins. You have all freedoms, no difficulty on that. Exercise them, but your freedoms must come to an end where my nose begins." Possibly same is the case with the laws which are restricting freedom of speech and expression. Because one has the freedom of expression, no difficulty on that. You have a freedom of speech also. But at the same time, they should have some circumspection, and that you will find in Article 19 into Bucket 2, which says that, 19.2 says that whenever it is a question of sovereignty and integrity of India, security of the state, friendly relations with the foreign states, public order, decency or morality, contempt of court, defamation, and incitement to an offense, if this is the nature of your freedom of speech or expression, they will be curtailed by law. Of course, there is a long list by which these freedoms of speech and expression are curtailed. To start with, you can find that in Section 124, Capital A of Indian Penal Code, the offense for sedition is provided for. Similarly, you will find laws preventing to extremism, terrorism, is restricted by providing unlawful activities into Bucket Prevention Act 1967, which is of course amended in 2012. Laws regulating to media, including the Press Council Act 1978, Cable Television Network into Bucket Regulation Act 1995, and of course Program and Advertisement Code, Cinematograph Act 1952. Laws governing information and communication technology, including the internet, of course, very much the hot topic of the day, because with the social media being so active and so easily available to people, without having any corresponding duty, they can tweet anything on the media, and then there are worlds created by that and creating problems for the people. Then laws prohibiting defamation and libel, criminal defamation punishable under Section 499 and 500 of the Indian Penal Code. Then ancillary laws restricting specific categories of content, including the Contempt of Courts Act 1971. Laws relating to obscenity essentially dealt with by Section 292 to 294 of Indian Penal Code. Section 153A of the same code punishes any word spoken or written or conduct promoting enmity between different groups on grounds of religion, race, place of birth, residence, language, etc. Friends, whenever we talk about freedom of speech, one must think about that there is a corresponding duty And that is why possibly it was very rightly referred to by your president, saying that it takes 2 years to learn after birth to speak. But then sometimes it happens that you spend entire life to understand what is not to be spoken. In Gujarati, there is a saying which says, anybody knows Gujarati here? Okay, no problem. I'll translate it for you. It says, Bole ena bor vechai. Bole ena bor vechai. Bor is the cherry. And na bole ema na ugun. There will be nine vices if you don't speak. And possibly that is why whenever there is a lecture in a law college and if somebody asks that, sir, what shall I do to be a good lawyer? Normally the advice given is you must know when not to speak. Lawyers are otherwise supposed to speak only and present the case of their client before the honorable judge. But then the advice given by the wise people is that advocate must know when not to speak, and especially those who will be practicing in trial court and will be having the cross-examination duty to be performed, they must know what is not to be asked to the witness. Because it may happen that your one question may dismantle your entire case which you might have built up after so much labor on the particular case. So that is why whenever it comes to about the freedom of speech and expression, not only that law is supposed to govern it, but it is something which inbuilt your, wisdom should also must let you know. And that is why it is said in the morning, what to speak, when to speak, where to speak, and how much to speak and not to speak. If all these things, if you put together, you'll find that this particular right, which is otherwise supposed to be the mother of all rights, and of course, a foundation of democracy, is going to be effectively implemented upon. Friends, Section 66(6)(a) of Information Technology Act of 2000 is one such example which you'll find that is having a very much relevance when we talk about the freedom of speech and expression. Similarly, friends, Cinematograph Act 1952, you'll find that normally individuals are not able to bring this question to forefront about their freedom of speech and expression. It is only when it becomes an institution like film industry or some more high-level projections that these particular questions are put forward and they are being discussed upon. Of course, the Law Commission is at present considering this with aspect because of the recent cases of Kanhaiya Kumar and that Hardik Patel from Gujarat, when we are talking about whether the government was right in curbing their freedom of speech by putting the charges of sedition and all those other charges. Now, this is very important. Every state is supposed to give freedom to freedom of speech to its citizens. But at the same time, the state is also having a duty to see that that particular right is not abused or is not so used that it creates problem for the nation as a whole. And that is why every right should have a duty. And when you are exercising this particular right of freedom of speech, you should be aware of your duty that you have to contribute constructively. And that is why in the morning it was referred to by Justice Arun Mishra ji that positive things and negative things. And that is why not only that, recently when Prime Minister was talking to the audience in that Goenka Awards, he said very nice thing. He said, earlier the press used to do what? An accident has taken, so it will be reported. A truck and a bicycle had an accident at such and such village. Then came the time when they said, a drunk car driver ran over the innocent man. That was the second stage. And the third stage is now, a BMW hit and ran over a Dalit person. You know, this is the way of changing the same thing. It was a freedom of speech right in those days also. It is a freedom of speech today also. But it depends upon how do you mold those particular things. And therefore, he concluded by saying that poor driver of BMW may not know that the person who is going to be hit or is hit is a Dalit person or not. So this is what the entire idea you can have about the duty towards exercising this particular right. We have so many panelists and we are running against the time, so I'll curtail my presentation here. Thank you very much.